This week on Maker Update, making tea the hard way, printing with molten metal, a nubbin for your lights, 1D Pac-Man, and wigs that listen. Hey, I'm Donald Bell, and welcome back to another Maker Update, the show where we update you on cool things makers are making. I hope you're doing well. I've got a fun show for you. Let's get started with the project of the week. The marble machine trend keeps building momentum. This time we've got a machine from the great British robot maker James Bruton. Inspired by his fellow countryman Colin Furze, he's made a deliriously complicated machine for brewing a cup of tea. What makes this different from your standard marble run machine is that there are gates and stages that move the cup at the bottom through different phases of the brewing process. And because two of these stages involve pouring, James had to tune the associated mechanism for a natural pouring motion and magnetically latch the pitcher in place to prevent boiling water or milk from whipping out when it tilts back. It's a goofy project with some real engineering challenges, and not only is it a fun video, but on his GitHub page, James provides all the details needed to recreate it from the CAD to the code. Check it out. Now for some news. On the MIT News blog, an interesting article and video detailing a process they call liquid metal printing. It's essentially a CNC-controlled plotter that draws molten aluminum into a bed of glass beads. The results are rough-looking by any standard, but the speed at which you can reproduce large-scale designs is unmatched. And compared to existing forms of CNC-controlled metal printing, similar to FDM 3D printing, you can get much stronger results this way that are less prone to cracking. It'll be interesting to see this technique evolve and maybe someday trickle down to something you and I can have access to. More projects. On his YouTube channel, Guy Dupont shows how he created this one-of-a-kind light dimmer using a ThinkPad-style keyboard nubbin. This is one of those ideas you chase down just because you wonder if it's even possible. And the cool part is, in the process, he discovered that these nubbins, or track points, can be picked up as inexpensive generic standalone boards with USB connections. So you can drop a track point into your next project without much fuss. It could be a great CyberDeck mouse. Another aspect of this project that's really a nice touch is he has one of the boards hosting a web app for dimming the lights, and the UI for the app, of course, is a nubbin. I also found two new super approachable projects on Adafruit. The first is this Pac-Man style one-button arcade game by Tim C. But instead of the typical Pac-Man maze, this is a 1D game where you just toggle his direction left and right to try to avoid a ghost attack. It's a fun idea and so ripe for an alt control interface if you just swap out the button for something silly. The other project is this guide from Erin St. Blaine on making a sound reactive light up Rapunzel wig. In this example, the hair slowly lights up more and more as you sing. But I could see this same idea repurposed for a magic wand that listens to you casting spells, or a crystal ball that glows brighter as you conjure the spirit world. Erin also did something cool here, especially since it's a guide written for beginners using the Circuit Playground instructional board. She includes a chapter on how she was able to use ChatGPT to guide the code writing process. There's a transcript of the prompts and dialogue she had with ChatGPT, and I found it all super interesting. I've never been good at code, and I'm relieved to see ways we can recognize how ChatGPT can help projects like this come to life. Now for some tips and tools. On the Core 77 blog, there's an interesting profile on the Chinese sign maker High-End LED Sings. That might be an accidental misspelling, but I think it works. What we're seeing here is an infinity mirror technique applied to Chinese characters. The results look incredible and definitely have me inspired to revisit infinity mirrors and think of other applications. There's also a new video out from the Crafsman that takes a look at the Japanese practice of soft vinyl casting called Sofubi. This is commonly used on Japanese vinyl toys and figurines, products that in other countries are typically churned out using injection molding and harder materials. The Sofubi technique is a very different, inherently slower process where the material coats the inside of a mold, cures, and is then yanked out. The softness of the material is actually necessary for pulling the casting out of the mold. I thought it was super interesting, so I encourage you to give it a watch. Links for everything are down in the description, in case you're new to the show. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, I thought I'd take a moment to point out that in addition to having all the boards and components you need for your electronics projects, DigiKey also has a vast selection of tools. There's an entire category filled with thousands of tools, from pliers and wrenches to specialized items like wire wrap tools, capacitor tuning tools, crimpers, calipers, and more. Spend a minute and I guarantee you'll find a tool you never knew existed. All right, and that does it for this week's show. Be sure to subscribe, leave a thumbs up, leave a comment. Big thanks as always to DigiKey for making this show possible, and thank you for watching. I'll see you soon.